A very good morning to all of you. Today our topic is MS Excel 2010 Cells, Rows and Column. Excel is a spreadsheet application capable of performing calculations, analyzing data and integrating information from different programs. By default, documents are saved in Excel with the .xlsx extension, whereas filename extension of the prior Excel version is .xls. So today we will learn about cells, rows and columns in Microsoft Excel. How data is shifted. Rows and columns in Excel 2010. MS Excel is in tabular format consisting of rows and columns. Row runs horizontally while column runs vertically. Each row is identified by a row number and each column is identified by a header. Microsoft Excel 2010 row numbers ranges from 1 to 10,48,576. In total, 10,48,576. Rows and columns ranges from A to XFD. In total, 16,384 columns, cell and cell content. Cells are the basic building block of a worksheet. They can contain a variety of cell content. Each rectangle in a worksheet is called a cell. It is an intersection of row and column. Each cell has a name or a cell address based on which column and row it intersects the cell address. If selected, cell appears in the name box. Here you can see G10 is selected to select a cell. Click a cell. When a cell is selected, you will notice border of the cell appear bold and column heading and row heading of the cell are highlighted. Release your mouse. The cell will stay selected until you click another cell in the worksheet. You can also navigate your worksheet and select a cell by using arrow keys of your keyboard. To select multiple cells, you can also select multiple cells at the same time. A group of cells is known as a cell range. You can also refer to a cell range using the cell addresses of the first and last cell in the cell range, separated by a colon. For example, a cell range that included cells A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 would be written as A1 colon A5. To select a range of cells, click and drag your mouse until all the adjoining cells you want are highlighted. Cell content. Each cell can contain its own text, formatting attributes, comments, formulas and functions. Now text. Cells can contain letters, numbers and dates. Formatting attributes. Cell can contain formatting attributes that can change the format of letters, numbers and dates. For example, dates can be formatted as m/dd/yyy or dd/mm/yy. Date, month, year. Comments. Cells can contain comments from multiple reviewers. Formulas and functions. Cells can contain formulas and functions that calculate cell values. For example, sum cell 1, cell 2 is a formula that can add the values in multiple cells. To insert content, click a cell to select it. Enter. Enter content into the selected cell using your keyboard. The content appears in the cell and in the formula bar. You can also enter or edit cell content from the formula bar to delete content within the cell. Now, how you can delete the cells? You want to delete, click the clear command on the ribbon. Drop-down menu will appear. Select clear contents to delete cells. You can delete. And okay, clear contents. There is an important difference between deleting the content and deleting the cell it. If you delete the cell by default, the cells underneath it will shift up and replace the deleted cell. To copy and paste cell content, selects the cell and cell you want to copy. Click the copy command and press Ctrl+C. Will change its appear. Select the cell or cell where you want to paste. content and click paste or press Ctrl plus V. To cut and paste cell content, select the cell and cells and choose cut. Select the cell and cells and click paste. The cut content will be removed from the original cells and entered into the highlighted cells. Copy paste in special way. You may not want to copy everything in some cases. For example, you want to copy only values or you want to copy only the formatting of cells. Select the paste special option from the drop down menu on the paste command. The various options available in paste special are all paste the cell contents, formats and data validation from the Windows clipboard. Formulas base formula but not formatting values. Paste only values. What the formulas formats paste is only the formatting of the source range. Comments paste the comments with respective cells. Validation pastes the validation applied in the cells. All using source theme piece formulas and all formatting, all accept borders, face everything except borders that appear in the source range. All these are paste specials, formulas and number formats, values and number formats, values and number formats, paste the results of formulas plus the number, all merging conditional formats. This icon is displayed only when the copied cells contain conditional formatting. When clicked, it merges the copied conditional formatting with any additional formatting in the destination range. Transpose changes the orientation of the copied range. Rows become columns and columns become rows. Any formula in the copied range are adjusted so that they work properly when transposed. Formatting cells. Select the cell or cell you want to format. Right-click the selected cells. A dialog box appear, format cells. Now you can change the alignment, font, border, etc. from the format cells dialog box. To drag and drop cells, select the cell you want to move, position your mouse and one of the outside edges of the selected cells. The mouse pointer changes from a white cross to a black cross arrow.